So, hello, I'm Michael Fetters. I'm professor of family medicine at the University of Michigan, and I'm also the co-director of the Michigan Mixed Methods Research Program. Today, I want to talk about integration. This is something that a lot of people find somewhat difficult to understand and abstract, but it's really pretty straightforward, and I think we can lead you through that today. All right, so I'm going to talk about the integration trilogy and its dimensions. And today we really want to get down into the details. I think you're going to find this interesting. This work comes from an editorial that I published with my co-author, Jose Francisco Molina Azorin, where we introduced the integration trilogy. It's an interesting article, I think, and goes into more depth. So if you have time, I would encourage you to consider reading it. So what is the research integration trilogy? The mixed methods research integration trilogy symbolizes how all dimensions of the mixed methods research approach can be integrated. So simply speaking, that's bringing together the philosophical, methodological, and methods. And these three comprise the key aspects of the mixed methods research trilogy. The philosophical component refers to the system of thought and theoretical underpinnings about the nature of reality, which is often called the ontology, knowledge, also thought of as epistemology, and values, that's axiology. The methodological component refers to the principles and underlying theory and system of methods you would use for conducting your mixed methods research. And then the methods refer to the actual techniques, approaches, and skills that you would use to conduct mixed methods research. Now, there are quite a few dimensions of integration, and we're going to talk about these today. So the integration dimensions can be seen as including the philosophical, theoretical, personal, team, literature view, research rationale, study purpose, aims and questions, research design, sampling, data collection, data analysis, interpretation, rhetorical, dissemination, and research integrity. So it might seem a little overwhelming, but let's go through these one at a time, and I think it will make sense. The philosophical dimension refers to orienting the research based on philosophical assumptions. It can be pragmatism, participatory transformative, critical realism, postmodernism, or dialectical pluralism. Each of these has ontological, epistemological, and axiological features. Relative to the theoretical dimension, researchers may incorporate theory at two levels. First, a researcher may incorporate theory from broad frameworks, so that could come from feminist theory or theory of justice. Second, a researcher, such as yourself, may apply one of the many middle-range theories. So examples might include the health beliefs model, social cognitive theory, or ecological theory, just to name a few. The researcher's personal dimension recognizes how you, as a mixed methods researcher, leverage your personal and professional experiences, and how these lend you, as a mixed methods researcher, to consider and hold valuable qualitative, quantitative, and mixed methods procedures for making sense of the world. Now we're going to talk about the team dimension of integration. So the team dimension relates to creating and orchestrating of mixed methods teams. Mixed methods teams can include both content experts, so that's individuals of different disciplinary backgrounds, but also a second team dimension, which can include methodology experts on the team, someone who has qualitative, quantitative, and mixed methods research expertise. To integrate at the team dimension, researchers seek to optimize each team member's contributions to produce the best quality mixed methods research. The literature review dimension. Now, this is interesting because through the literature review dimension, we want you to thoroughly examine the existing literature about both qualitative and quantitative research, and illustrate the need to conduct both of these. So for example, for qualitative research, we'll need you to illustrate the need for in-depth description or to understand the how and why about a particular phenomenon. And with quantitative research, we'd be looking more at trends in a population, associations, causality, etc. So this will be relative to the phenomena that you're interested in. And this will then illustrate the need to produce knowledge about the substantive topic from a mixed methods perspective. The research rationale dimension is about how you're going to conduct an integrated mixed methods study. So this dimension encompasses citing a rationale for conducting an integrated mixed methods research study. Mixed methods research rationales can include offsetting strengths and weaknesses, comparing, complementing, or expanding, in other words, developing or building, and promoting social justice. In mixed methods, researchers need to compose an overarching mixed methods research purpose, and they may state 1, qualitative, quantitative, and mixed methods aims, or 2, multiple mixed methods aims composed of both quantitative aims and qualitative questions. Now we're going to talk about the research design dimension now. So there's kind of a lot going on here, but I'll try and make it easy for you to understand. Integration in the research design dimension means scaffolding the work in core designs and or advanced designs. Core designs can include convergent, exploratory sequential, or explanatory sequential. Advanced designs, which are sometimes also called complex designs, can include intervention, case study, evaluation, participatory, or instrument or app development designs. And given the advent of multiple apps, this has become a very popular design now. Some also use emergent design. This basically means that the design is emerging as the study unfolds, though will still often follow some combination of the core advanced designs. Through the sampling dimension, researchers consider the sampling relationship and the timing. The sampling relationship considers the relationship of the qualitative and quantitative sample. That is, it can be an identical sample, a nested sample, separate samples, or multi-level samples. Second is the timing. So you might have data collection occurring at the same time, or it may be occurring at different times for both the qualitative and the quantitative data. The data collection dimension is a very active area of research in mixed methods right now, and it's a really interesting area to understand more about. I like to think about what is the intent relative to the mixed methods research procedures. So when you're planning a study, you need to think about how you're going to bring your qualitative and quantitative data together. That can occur through comparing, through matching, through diffracting, through expanding, through constructing a case, through connecting, through building, through generating and validating a model, and through embedding. And once you've collected your data, we need to think about integration through the data analysis dimension. We're going to talk about two possibilities. First is the intramethod analytics, which involves analyzing each type of data within the respective qualitative and quantitative methods and using core integration analytics. So the core integration analytics that you might use after you've analyzed your qualitative data and your quantitative data separately include following a thread, spiraling, or back and forth exchanges. For advanced intermethod analytics, the goal is to do one of the following: do a transformation of qualitative to quantitative data, or a transformation of quantitative to qualitative data. You may also choose to create a joint display. You might use social network analysis. You might use qualitative comparative analysis. There's also repertory grid or other scale development techniques, geographic information systems mapping techniques, and iterative and longitudinal queries of the data. Next up, in terms of mixed methods integration is the interpretation dimension. This involves your interpreting the meaning of the mixed findings, where there are related data, drawing meta-inferences or conclusions based on interpreting the qualitative and quantitative findings, and then examining for fit of the two types of data. So when you bring the qualitative and quantitative data together, is there confirmation? Is there complementarity? Do you find expansion or discordance? And when the results do conflict or there's discordance, you have procedures to use for handling this, including reconciliation, initiation, bracketing, and exclusion. The rhetorical dimension of integration refers to how mixed methods researchers are creating or adapting terminology intentionally and thoughtfully to reflect the mixed methods approach. This involves writing with an integrated structure to illustrate the mixed methods dimension. It involves structuring the findings in a narrative using contiguous or weaving presentations. It might involve using metaphors to write about integration or composing integrated prose so you can effectively illustrate the added value of mixed methods findings. The dissemination dimension. This is where you start getting the word out about what you've done. This can occur through two approaches, intrapublication and interpublication. Intrapublication refers to how mixed methods researchers convey their findings to others through publication in a single paper. So there could also be not only a single publication, but also multiple papers that all use mixed methods approaches together. Contrast that with interpublication. Interpublication involves publishing a qualitative paper, a quantitative paper, a mixed methods paper, and possibly a methodological paper. But it could be any combination of these, such that there's only one qualitative paper and several mixed methods papers or a methodological paper. Of course, in any research, we need to think about research integrity, and this is also an important dimension for integration. In quantitative methods, people classically think about things like validity and reliability. In qualitative methods, thinking about trustworthiness. And in mixed methods, language has evolved to include the language of validity, legitimation, and integrity. It's still evolving, so keep your eyes open. Details about the Research Integration Trilogy. And this is how you, as a mixed methods researcher, should strive to attend to all components of the Mixed Methods Integration Trilogy, that is, the philosophical, methodological, and methods. And I hope these details will help you conceptualize and conduct your own mixed methods projects. As a reminder, if you are interested in getting more information about how to do mixed methods research, I would encourage you to find us at the Mixed Methods Program here at the University of Michigan. There I serve with my co-director, John Creswell, and the executive committee of Jane Foreman, Timothy Guterman, Arden Morris, and Sarah Warber. You may also be interested in looking at our website at www.mixedmethods.org. Finally, I want to thank my co-editor, Jose Francisco Molina Azorin, who co-authored this publication with me. Thank you and good luck with your mixed methods projects.